Bit more about this case. Former Chicago Police Superintendent Eddie Johnson is here live in studio to talk a little bit about no-knock warrants, because people are concerned, those who would watch that video. First of all, it's always jarring when you see a shooting, let alone somebody be killed on camera.
Absolutely.
It should be jarring to the human conscience. But police are doing this very difficult job. They have a no-knock search warrant. They're seeking a potential suspect in a homicide case. And they go into this apartment and there's somebody on a couch. First of all, let's get to no-knock warrants. What does it mean? From your perspective, what does a no-knock search warrant mean?
So a no-knock search warrant for law enforcement means you're coming across a very dangerous situation and possibly armed. You know, anytime you're asking for no-knock, it's a dangerous and tenuous situation. A lot of times you use it for dope warrants, but you also use it for very violent offenders.
Okay, so they would have received this warrant as an exception because they aren't issued easily.
Correct.
In a case where they are concerned or fearful for a loss of life.
Correct.
They know that this is a violent offender. And according to the notes, again, we're still getting so much information. This young man, Amir Locke, was not named on the warrant. He just happened to be in the house. Does that matter?
I mean, it's tragic, but they don't know that the police officers that responded did not know who that was.
Right.
And when they go into that apartment or that residence, they see someone unfolding from a blanket and see a weapon in their hand, then that's a safety issue. Mm-hmm. So I have to tell you, Adrian, from what I saw of the video at this point, mm-hmm. it appears that they did it correctly.
Mm-hmm.
You know, now I don't profess to be an expert of the laws in Minnesota, but here in Chicago, the way that that was executed is tragic. It is. It's tragic. Anytime you lose a life, it's tragic, especially when that guy wasn't even named in the warrant. But from what it appears on the video that I saw, it appears that they did follow protocol.
This might be a difficult question because some people are asking, well, if the gun wasn't being pointed at officers, then that somehow would be a different scenario for an officer than if the barrel of that gun was pointed directly at them. Does that make a difference when you're an officer going into a situation that could be hostile?
No, you don't have to wait for somebody to point a weapon at you and fire it before you try to defend yourself. So it's, you know, it's a dicey situation, and it just illustrates the difficulty of being a police officer and executing a search warrant. Remember, those officers don't know what they're going into when they go through that door. So they're on high alert, and then when you see a weapon, you don't know what that person is going to do with it, so you don't have to wait for them to point it at you.
A lot of times we're hearing a story, we get a piece of video out that mm-hmm. could be extremely controversial, and then this story gets compared to other very high-profile cases where there could have been a no-knock warrant or somebody was killed in this line of fire that
right.
police
right.
officers and whoever's on the other side of the door are in. Is that appropriate?
No, I would caution people not to judge this case by any others. Let it stand on its own merits, because if you do that, then you have preconceived notions of what you think. So look at it for what it is. Let's let the rest of the investigation play out and then judge this one on its own merit.
All right. Thank you so much, Eddie Johnson, for joining us, a former chief of police, chief superintendent. I always say chief, but
That's
it's
okay.
superintendent. You know what I mean.
Yeah.
Thanks for being with us.
Thank you.
We have to turn to thank you so much for watching. Make sure to click on the red subscribe button below so you can get more of News Nation's fact-driven, unbiased coverage.